Hello, hi friends. In this video, we are going to see how to enable KEDA on a Kubernetes cluster. In one of the earlier videos, we saw how to use the add-on available with Azure Kubernetes Service or AKS managed Kubernetes cluster on Microsoft Azure, which has built-in support for KEDA, and using a flag or using a feature called as enable KEDA, we were able to enable the KEDA related functionality for Azure Kubernetes cluster. In this video, we are going to see how to deploy KEDA without using this add-on. So assume that you have a Kubernetes cluster available. I'm using Azure Kubernetes Service, but this can be any other Kubernetes cluster, and we want to install KEDA on that. The other scenario could be, like I showed in the earlier video, the version of the KEDA that is supported on AKS or Azure Kubernetes Service is dependent on the version of the Kubernetes cluster. Like 1.28 version has support for KEDA 2.11.2. But assume that we want to use the latest version of KEDA. When we head to the KEDA website, we see that the latest version is 2.12, which is not currently supported by default on Azure Kubernetes Service or AKS. But let's say we want to have the latest and greatest features of KEDA available on our Kubernetes cluster. In that case, we can disable the KEDA which comes with Azure Kubernetes Service, or if it is a different Kubernetes cluster, not a AKS cluster, and we want to deploy the version 2.12 on that Kubernetes cluster, we will use Helm charts to do the deployment, and we will see what are the steps which are required. So I've gone ahead and created a AKS cluster similar to the earlier one using a PowerShell script, which runs a set of Azure CLI commands or AZ CLI commands. And I use the same set of commands here as well, using AZ AKS create and passing different parameters like the resource name, what is the name of the cluster, the node count, Kubernetes version, and to attach the Azure Container Registry. These are the different parameters that this script takes and which I explained in the earlier video. If you would like to understand more about that, you can watch the earlier video. Now, the difference between previous one and this script is we have disabled this enable KEDA flag, which means that the Kubernetes cluster is created without having any KEDA related resources on that. We can verify this quickly by going into our kubectl or the command line and run this command get pods in the namespace kube system. And we see that there is no KEDA related pod or KEDA related resource created here. So we have a cluster which doesn't currently have anything related to KEDA. Now, to install KEDA, as I said, I'm going to use the Helm chart, which is provided by KEDA again. So we are going to add a repository for KEDA core, which is part of GitHub. This is the Helm repo, and then we update it so that we have the latest definitions or latest information related to the KEDA repository. And then we use the Helm upgrade command to install KEDA, and we specifically mention the version that we want to install, which is 2.12.1 in this case, and we also want to create a namespace with the name as KEDA. So with this, I'm going to run this PowerShell script, and we are going to install this KEDA using deploy-keda.ps1, which is the name of the PowerShell script. So we see that I had run this previously. So the KEDA core already exists, and it has gone ahead and installed a release, Helm release, with the name as KEDA, and it has created the KEDA related resources. We run the kubectl get pods and the namespace as KEDA, because we specified that we want to create a namespace for this particular KEDA installation, and all the resources related to KEDA would be parked under this KEDA namespace. So that is how we can verify that the KEDA admission webhook controller, the KEDA operator, and the matrix server or matrix API server all have been created under the KEDA namespace. I also use the Lens IDE, which helps us to visualize the state of the Kubernetes cluster. And under the custom resources, if I go and quickly see which are the resources available I can see under definitions, we have the scaled object, then we have the scaled job, cluster trigger authentication, and trigger authentication. These four resources are created as part of the Helm chart, which is deployed, which deployed the KEDA related resources. We can also go and look at the pods directly here in the Lens UI, and let's look at the KEDA operator. Here we can see that under the labels, we have the 2.12.1 label for KEDA as the version. So this is one way of verifying that the right version of KEDA is installed. There is also another way which we can verify this by going into the Azure portal and looking at the particular cluster that we have. And on that particular AKS cluster, if we go into the workloads section, or if we go into the namespaces, since we created a namespace for KEDA, we can see there is this KEDA namespace here. Under the workloads, if we go, we can see we are looking at the kube system right now, but if we go under the KEDA, we can see 3 minutes ago, which was our Helm upgrade command, when it ran as part of the PowerShell script, it has created these three objects: KEDA admission webhook, KEDA operator, and KEDA operator matrix API server. And same way, if we go into the custom resources, we should be able to find the four CRDs which were created 3 minutes ago. So these are the different ways in which we can verify that KEDA related resources have been created on our Kubernetes cluster. And this demonstration shows that we can use a Helm chart to deploy KEDA on a supported Kubernetes version. I hope you found this useful. If you want to learn more about KEDA, you can head over to my channel and you can find a playlist here which contains multiple KEDA related videos. And I've also done various public talks under the community events. So if you look under the virtual community events, you will find more than one talk related to KEDA. I hope you found this information useful. If you find it something useful for your use, please hit the subscribe button, like my channel, or like the video and subscribe to my channel and share it with your friends. Thanks for watching. Until next time, code with passion and strive for excellence.